Hello friends, welcome to Yogic and Modern Science. Today I'll be continuing from my previous episode, and that episode was about the new shape of universe theory. And just a few days back, the scientist came up with a new shape of the universe, and now they are saying that universe, the whole universe has a boundary, and it is curved and spherical in shape, okay, not a flat as was previously considered. Now I'm making this episode just because in yogic science we have the complete system of the universe and all the components of universe. Scientists, the contemporary scientists, okay, they have become able to explain only the universe, and they say universe is curved, spherical, which we have been saying it for the last 2 years. Now, according to yogic science, there are three systems which are working together. They exist together. They are all simultaneous. Now, what are these three components of the universe? One is a very, very static component, and universe has the shape of a sphere, not round sphere, but it is elliptical, and it is lying horizontally. I can demonstrate the complete system, okay, by this figure. You can see this horizontal sphere, okay, this horizontal sphere is your universe, the whole universe, right, which nowadays scientists are talking about. But in yogic science, we have a second component also. Around this horizontal universe, which is spherical and elliptical, okay, there is a vertical sphere also, right? And this is the energy of consciousness. According to the yogic science, this is the energy of consciousness, or pure energy of consciousness, you can say. Now, how can we have the idea of this pure consciousness? What is this energy of pure consciousness? According to yogic science, okay, which is prevalent in all the scriptures of almost all the religions, the nature of this energy of consciousness is threefold. It is shabd, word, light, prakash, and power, shakti. So these are the three components of this vertical energy, this sphere of vertical energy, okay. So it has got three components. It is made up of three things, okay, or it has the nature of shabd, the word, right, the light, and the power, okay. So this is the second component, okay, of this whole universe. So universe is not only a horizontal sphere, okay, but there is also a vertical sphere of energy of consciousness, right, which is made up of sound, shabd, light, and power. So this is the second component. Now third component, it is a little visible. You can see inside this universe, this horizontal universe, okay, you can see the small plus sign. Okay, now friends, this plus sign is nothing but the system of this the system of these two spheres. Okay, in plus, okay, there is horizontal sphere and there is vertical sphere, vertical and horizontal, and it is making plus. Now this whole system which is making plus, it is like this, this and this. It is making a plus. Now this plus is there inside this this horizontal sphere of universe, and there are many plus, okay, which has been created, okay, or which has been created under the influence of these two components. and these plus are known as jivatmas. Now this is the complete system according to yogic science, the complete system of this whole universe, right? The multiple jivatmas which are inside this whole universe, right? This is the third component. Okay, first was this universe and second was this vertical sphere of energy. Okay, you can call it 1, 2, 3 in any way you like. Okay, but this is the complete system of three components of this whole universe. Now I'm just showing you the actual shape of this plus, this jivatma, okay, which is there in this horizontal sphere of universe. This is the actual shape of the plus, okay, which are uncountable in this whole universe. And in the universe there is nothing but this plus energy, this jivatmas. It is full of this jivatmas, this whole universe. And because of this jivatmas, all the creations are happening, right? I'll go into the details of creation inside the this horizontal universe later on in some other episode, okay? But for today I just want to explain to you what are the main components of this whole universe, right? So this is the actual shape of this plus, and this plus is also, it has also got some kind of movement, right? It has got low energy, okay, but under the influence of the conscious energy, okay, which is, you know, running around this whole horizontal universe, okay, due to that energy, okay, it is able to create something more, right? And it can get into any kind of shape. Okay, you can see in this whole universe, you know, the planets are being formed, the whole, you know, Akash Ganga and the, you know, black hole and so many other heavenly bodies, they are being created, they are being destroyed. Okay, so many things are happening in this whole universe. Okay, so this is happening because of these three systems, because of the combination of these three systems, right? And they remain together always. Okay, so this is one component, okay, which is called jivatma. It has its own energy, although it is lower in energy, okay, but under the influence of the higher, which is pure energy, okay, which runs around this whole universe vertically, right? So now in the next episode, how the creation takes place inside this vertical, horizontal universe, okay, I'll explain all these things in the next episode. So for today I just want to explain to all the contemporary scientists and the people who are interested in science that we not only have this static universe, okay, around this universe, this whole universe, okay, there is a system of the energy of consciousness, okay, which is composed of sound, light and the power, okay, and inside the, under the influence of these two components, okay, there are so many jivatmas, okay, they are being created and they have been created, okay, and because of these three systems, this whole creation is taking place. Thank you.